This is TWiT.
Were you aware, Megan, that your iPhone hates helium?
My iPhone did not tell me that yet. Apparently, I haven't been around helium.
Well, there is that. Apparently, Morris Hospital in the Chicago area installed a new GE MRI machine. And in the process of the install, there was a helium leak that at first went undetected. Suddenly, throughout the hospital, newer model iPhones and Apple Watches were out of nowhere becoming inoperable, 40 of them to be exact. Meanwhile, Android devices and older iPhones continued plugging along. It turns out that Apple replaced bulky quartz components in its newer devices with micro electromechanical systems, timing oscillators, and that the helium molecules penetrated those MEMS chips and rendered the devices temporarily useless. Apple actually indicates in a section of its user guide to a warning against exposure to gases such as helium, which they say, quote, may damage or impair iPhone functionality. So this was obviously a big test of that. If this happens to you, Megan, ever, have no fear. It should be fully recoverable if you unplug the device and wait a week. Waiting a week might be hard for you.
What do I do about my Apple Watch? I can't unplug my Apple Watch. It's unplugged.
Good question. I don't know on that one. That's a good question.
I guess turn it off, maybe.
Yeah, turn it off. And just wait.
Yeah, I love that.
Wait a long time.
My favorite part of the story is that Apple's like, duh, we obviously knew.
It's in the manual. Yeah. You didn't read the helium section of the manual?
Also, it's like very high levels of helium we're talking about. Like if you just took a balloon and shot it at your, like a helium balloon, that wouldn't happen.
Although iPhone would speak in really high voice.
Siri would be like, very high voice.
That'd be so great. When your iPhone detects that there's helium in the room, suddenly Siri is really high in her warning.
Yes. I found this on the web.
That would be awesome.
So I think that this much helium is bad for you.
Yeah.
Like just bad for you as a human too. So it's not like we're going to be experiencing this, but I highly recommend if you've got like 45 minutes to spare and then you really interested in like weird technology troubleshooting, check out the Reddit thread because it's like, you know, you can go down that Reddit rabbit hole of like, well, I once found this and it was caused by this after we did this. It's, I don't know, I enjoyed it.
Mm-hmm. And I should also point out that iFixit's Kyle Waynes, who we had on the show, I think last week or the week before, he has a blog post up on iFixit. And I think that was that raised a lot of awareness around this helium iPhone thing, too. So the more you know about your iPhone.